Roger, in conclusions discussed this afternoon about the work of the Troika in the four countries concerned, there is a huge critic about how this Troika worked in terms of transparency, in terms of responsibility, in terms of everything, and also in terms of negative impact on employment in these countries. What are your comments about this?
Well, the Troika was tasked with the job of trying to sort out the problems in particularly the Club Med countries. And what is important to understand is that the problems didn't arise from the Troika. The problems arose from the euro currency, which created these enormous imbalances across Europe and resulted in countries like Greece and Spain becoming hopelessly uncompetitive and indebted. So the Troika, if you like, is like a sticking plaster. And sticking plasters don't always work, especially where the underlying issue is really quite serious. So I'm not really in a position to comment on the detail of the Troika's work, but they were told to impose austerity and they imposed austerity. They might have done it in a more courteous way or done it with a smile, but that's what they did, that's what they were asked to do. And the result is inevitable, and the result is massive unemployment. And the thing that astonishes me is that back in the UK, where I come from, there is at least one party, the Liberal Democrats, who've coined a slogan saying, in Europe, in work. Whereas if you actually go and look at what's going on in the Eurozone, it's a case of in Europe, out of work. I believe the unemployment rate across the Eurozone is about 11%. If you look at the EFTA countries in Europe, which are not in the EU, the unemployment rate is under 4%. That makes the case. The EU is a job destruction machine. I don't think the Troika could have behaved very much differently given the brief that it had, nor can it solve the problem while the euro remains in place. I mean, we in the UK have a system called the Barnett Formula, under which the Treasury in London provides year after year after year quite substantial funds to Scotland, which would otherwise be, if you like, a bit more like Greece in the Eurozone. If you want to keep a currency union together where there are big imbalances between the economies of different areas, the only real solution is major fund transfers. That's what we do within the sterling currency union between England and Scotland. It's what you can't do in the Eurozone because there simply isn't the political acceptance in Northern Europe of the need to send those very large sums of money, not once or twice as a bailout, but every year, year after year, as long as you keep the euro going. There isn't that political consent to do that, so there is no solution to the euro crisis. All they can hope to do is mitigate some of the damage on the way. Well, I would say none of the above. Neither of them appeals to me strongly. Mr. Juncker is an absolutely fanatical dyed-in-the-wool integrationist, but I don't think Mr. Schulz is much better, and I think I shall spoil my ballot paper.